When Bell read accounts of Garfield's suffering, he became obsessed with developing a less barbaric method of locating the bullet.
This could be the trick. And he won't feel a thing.
You sure?
Positive.
Bell abandoned his other work, left his pregnant wife in Boston, and shut himself away in a small lab on Connecticut Avenue, not far from the White House. Drawing on the principles he had used in the telephone, Bell and his assistant invented the world's first metal detector. Bliss had been dismissive of Bell's efforts at first, but now he was growing desperate.
I'll take that.
Mr. Tainter is very familiar with the apparatus.
I think it best.
It is a delicate procedure.
I think it best.
As you wish.
Bell had already pushed the boundaries of science in developing his device.
Proceed.
But was now suddenly up against a new complication. Dr. Bliss had stated publicly many times that the bullet was lodged in the president's right side. It now became clear that he expected Bell to find it, where Bliss had said it was. The doctor wouldn't even allow Bell to examine the left side of the president's body.
Maybe there. I don't know. Have a listen.
I don't think so.
I'm sorry, the signal is much weaker than it was in our tests.
But it is a signal.
I don't think it's conclusive.
But it confirms all the other evidence. I think we can declare your test a success, Mr. Bell. We thank you for all of your hard work, but now the president must have his rest. Thank you.